A technical difficulty there. So thanks for joining in. Just wait a few minutes to see if anyone else is coming out to play. So today's Sunday, all day, apparently. Hey Frankie, how are you? Thanks for joining in. Looks like it's a bit cloudy, shock horror, but good enough. It's still bright. That's the important part. Hey, thanks for joining in. So yeah, it's a bright day, sunny day. It's dry. Currently, wherever you are, wherever I am anyway, certainly. Wherever I am, I'm here. Happy Sunday, Frankie, thank you. So there has been we're going through a lot, we know this, and I certainly yesterday I enjoyed talking about nurturing our inner child, and I'm looking around to a few places that I'm part of a few sites, whatever you want to call them, groups, that's the word. And they are reiterating, one of the groups particularly is reiterating the inner child. So I certainly, it's self-nurturing. We need to nurture ourselves. That's our job, really is. And it is difficult. It's like, you know, there's a lot of stuff going on about, in other news, and I won't. I'm really trying not to kind of actually say anything. I think we all, well, you know, we all have an idea about what there's a particular few things happening in this country that are bringing up a lot of hard feelings for people, and it's reactionary, and it's it doesn't bode well for one's own self-care. So, I've read a few things that have made me shiver, and so I mean, I certainly read these things to keep up to speed what's going on in people's lives or in the general scenario. And it doesn't. I'm not in any way condoning them. Yeah, I don't condone them, of course not. I appreciate that that's how people feel, and I try and stay away from even reacting to them. Whatever about my own reactions and my own feelings about them, I do keep that stuff to myself because there's some stuff I don't want to engage in. I certainly I look at it, I see it, I absorb it, I try and, you know, try and unabsorb it afterwards or whatever you want. And I'm finding it difficult to speak today for some reason or other. I'm trying not to get myself down. I'm trying not to dig too much of a hole for myself. But hey, Dave, how are you? It's again, it's going back to my own words for myself. I say this to myself now, how, mind how you, I feed my mind and mind how I feed my heart. And the thing about that is, yeah, one needs to appreciate what's going on around them. I certainly do, big time, and know that for balance, it's not all, you know, happy clappy, hippy dippy sort of stuff. It's not. There's a lot of dark energy out there, a lot of anger out there, frustration, and I respect that. I totally respect that, and I acknowledge it. And okay, with the isolation scenario, you know, in a physical sense, I stay away from it. Obviously, that's fair enough because, you know, there's all that space minding and the distancing that we have, and that's okay. But there are some people who just, I feel, I'm going to avoid them anyway. That's the best thing I can say for myself. Whatever you do is your business. and what we can do with that, what that is doing for me though. This is the important, this is the part, this is where, this is the nut of my little speaking here. It makes me realize how blessed I am personally with what I have, with who I have around me, in the greater sense. And I do feel that when I do go down those places, hey Caroline, thanks for joining in, and Pat. When I do go down those places, when I do read those articles, I realize it makes me, it reminds me of what I do have. So yes, I am thankful for those scenarios because they're over there. Morning from Dublin. Hi, thanks, Caroline. Oh yeah, let me know where you're there. Thanks for reminding me, Caroline. Actually, let me know where you're watching from, please, if you don't mind. Anyway, but those scenarios that I read, the less lit stuff, reminds me of what I do for myself to keep lit. Now I'm not going to go into this toxic positivity lark. I don't do that either because I mean, okay, you may have noticed I am totally watching my language on this these broadcasts, and that's cool because whatever. I do I do have other ways of speaking, which I'm cho choosing not to here. So I leave that for my poetry or for other places. But my point in saying that is I'm grateful for what I have. I'm grateful for who I have in my life. I'm thankful, and I appreciate who I am and where I am in my life. And so thank you. So maybe I'll share that with you, is that we all appreciate who we are and where we are. And I certainly thank my inner child for helping me get through a lot of this stuff. And I thank my friends obviously as well, my family, and and you, my digital family, my friends, and Ormo Road, nice and South Belfast, nice and Frankie, thank you. Caroline from Dublin. So the stuff that we may pass by, the stuff that we may read, the less lit stuff, as I call it, and whatever, that's not a judgment, that's an observation from me, my perspective, nothing else, serves me as a reminder to go the other way. So because I have a choice to go down this path or this path, whatever those are, and I'm choosing the road with the more lights. That's my business. Anyway, speaking of lights, lovely segue, nice one. I like that. Speaking of lights, here we have Sunday light. This light for Sunday. This is, hey David, how are you? This light is for us to bring into our hearts, bring into our chest, bring in, and to beam out to help us. And when we look at ourselves in a reflective surface or a mirror, we blow ourselves a kiss. We see the little light beaming out from our chest and say thank you. So thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you to our inner child. Thank you to our for our inner love, for our self-love. And we give ourselves a hug. We give ourselves a little pat on the back. We blow ourselves a kiss. We say thank you. Thank you for this day, because all we have is now. And there you go. So, and don't worry, be happy. So now we're going to light the sage. The sage will help us cleanse our area. And bring some. Watch your hands, and this hands were short. And ask that the spirits, our spirit guide, our ancestors, and our descendants, and our higher selves, our future selves, help us with today's meditation. So we're going to go into a 6 minute, 5 6 minute Reiki meditation. And before we do that, I'm going to ask you to join with me in a little smile. We're going to smile for about 15 seconds, and that will release our serotonin, which is our feel-good chemical. And so if you care to join me for that, please, after three. One, two, three. Yeah, that will help us brighten our day. And so, if you sit comfortably, I will ask our higher selves to join us for this Reiki meditation. And I will ask you to say to yourself, I am open and ready to receive. And those words will let the energy know that you are allowing it to go to you, through you, to you. And so, I'll see you in about 5 minutes. And again, thanks for joining in. Right. Do some bells first. Open up our chakras. So, Now, just bring ourselves back. Just put one hand over the other. And we let the light in our hands grow, glow. We let it get brighter and brighter. We bring the light into our chest, into our heart. We hold it there for a few minutes, a few moments. We let that light get brighter and brighter inside us, and let that bring peace and love to us today to help us get through the day. And then we open up the light to the world and let the energy go where it needs to go. Stretch. Oh yeah. Wiggle our fingers and wiggle our toes, and we let the energy go where it needs to go. And now I shall bring us back with the bells and peace and love this Sunday to you too, Chris. Thank you. Thank you for the reminder. That's what slows down for the chakras. Hey Paul, thanks for joining in. So we're going to do some drumming in a minute, and but before that, I am going to read a card from this book here, The Medicine Woman Inner Guidebook. And we'll make sure they're all there, and we see what little messages we have for today. What we need to know, or I mean, and yeah. If this resonates with you, well done. If it doesn't, that's fair enough too. No worries. Don't try and make it fit, because that's not how card reading works. So there you go. So today, the Harvest Lodge of Stones. So it's a close up of the card there. Okay. Might be a bit of a read on it. Let's see how it goes. Harvest Lodge of Stones, plenty for all. Now, prayer. The more I have cared for the more the earth has given to me. I am wealthy and live in the paradise of my own creation. All I have ever wanted is here now, a part of me. I have loved Earth's beauty and cast my love upon her. The greatest of my dreams can now be seen in Earth's form. I shall enjoy this the best of times and release all guilt from success. This is the moment I have long awaited. The Great Mother and I are one. The lesson. Great Mother's womb is filled with plenty. The future looks secure. You have stored what is needed and passed on your wisdom. You have replenished the source of your supply. You will be well fed. Look to your house of wares. For everything you have gained, have you given its seed to future generations? You are now in charge of the whole system. It must work well beyond your earthly life. Who will carry on and how? Has your blueprint You may want to note the history of your success for those who come behind you searching. The hungry will be fed by what you leave for them. What do you bequeath to your children? What is the life way you leave them? So we have plenty inside us to get us through. Hey, Yora, thanks for joining in. We've plenty inside us to and how we adapt and survive and adapt and thrive. Okay, to thrive beyond survive is a good thing, and how we pass it on to future generations, how our children see us, how our youngers see us as elders, no matter where we are, no matter how old we are, there's still people younger than us, and we need it is our duty to be examples to them, and how we conduct ourselves, and how we and what we leave behind, whether it be good deeds, good thoughts, and stuff like that. And so I certainly believe we're doing very well. There's a lot of beautiful examples Certainly from what I'm reading, and I'm taking some of them examples and using them in my life as well. So well done, all you all for leading me into a nice brighter place too, and thank you for that. And so it's yeah, I shall enjoy this, the best of times, and release all guilt from success. Okay, not exactly the best of times currently, that's fair enough, but to release all guilt, that there, to release all guilt from say, for example, for not writing that fantastic play, not writing that film script, not writing that poem, not this, not that, whatever. As the saying goes, if all you did today was breathe, well done. That's thank you. Well done, you. You breathed. You got out of bed. I mean, yeah, whatever. You don't even have to get out of bed. That's cool. You could be watching this in bed too. Well done. I could actually be doing this in bed, except I don't wouldn't be able to drum properly. That's all. Fair enough. If I could drum in bed, I would. Anyway, so yeah, so well done you for getting up today, for realizing yourself, and I mean that realizing yourself, your self-worth. You are worthy. We're all worthy of a smile. We're all worthy of self-love. This is the sort of stuff we need to pass on to the younger generation, fair enough, and also to help perhaps the older generation, because I feel maybe they weren't given the opportunities to know. To love themselves. I could be wrong, and that's cool too. Being wrong, makes you learn to be right or whatever. So, but I, we'll see how that goes. But self-love, that's your job. Always will be. Whatever else you ever do in your whole life, love yourself. Winner. So now I'm gonna do some drums, and yeah, I'm gonna do read a bit of Sister Stan in a minute after that. So, but first of all. Going to do, we'll do the rattle first. Just gonna warm my drum up and do. So I hope you all as much as you can, I hope you all get out for a bit of a walk today. Or even open your windows. Get some fresh air. I'm gonna shake the rattle. The rattle will connect us to the heavens. The drum will connect us to the earth, and we will be in between, like a child of Gaia, Mother Earth. Okay, so. Yeah, there we are. Welcome back. And howdy, Adriana. Thanks for that. I love to you too this Sunday. Really appreciate it. And you're welcome. And Colleen, how are you? Thanks for joining in. And Paul and everyone else. It's Adrienne, Orla, Paul again, Chris, David, Frankie, Caroline, Dave. And Ash and Frankie again. Okay, so listen, thanks for joining in. Really appreciate it. We're going to do a sort of Reiki session now. But first of all, I'm going to read from Sister Stan to see what she has to say today, because I do like her philosophy. I may read the word God. Sister Stan is a Christian. That's she. God is her God, and there you go. Our Yahweh is her God. When I say that word, choose a word that suits you. Spirit, universe, source, goddess, Dave, whatever, Sid, Joe, as in Joe Strummer, not me, or me, whatever. If you want, I don't mind. I don't care. Winner. But whatever way, whatever word you choose to use, this is her word, and fair play to her. And she's a good head. Look her up, check her out, Sister Stan. She has a place in Stanhope Street in Dublin. I think it's Stanhope Street, and it's a sanctuary, it's called. Check her work out. She's really cool. She's a cool head. So, winner for that. And I shall go through towards the end of the book. And here we go. Divine blessings, giving life to my inner being, offering opportunities to recognize my gifts, realize my potential, live my dreams, is already within. Doing, the energy to move with focused attention, accomplish specific tasks, achieve goals. The best that I could be this day is already in. We already have our divine light, our source light, our universal love inside us already. It's some people don't know that they have the choice to love themselves. It's not only a choice to love yourself, it's a duty. It's your job. Like, seriously, I mean that. I mean, I love loving myself, because it's the best job, one of the best jobs I've ever had. And I suggest that you take that employment for yourselves and be self-employed in your self-love, because it's your duty and your job to do so. And it's a great thing. It really is. Give yourself joy. Love yourself. Blow yourself a kiss in the mirror every time you see yourself, or a reflective surface, or a car going by, a bus going by. Have a quick scope. How are you doing, love? All this stuff, right? It's great. Seriously, look, yeah, brings beams of smileage to me. And doing, the energy to move with focused attention, accomplish specific tasks, and achieve goals. Your goal today is get through the day with your head held high and a smile in your heart, and the ability to look back and say, today was a good day. Thank you very much. Wake up in the mornings with the same thing. Thank you for today. Okay, because that's hey Dave, thanks for joining in. That's your job. Smile, love yourself. Give yourself a hug, give yourself treat yourself well. There you go. Right, so I'm going to do some Reiki now. This energy, first of all, thanks again for joining in. Really appreciate it. The Reiki energy we will use for ourselves, obviously, as always, and we will send it out to frontline workers. Yeah, there you go. And whoever else, your loved ones, your family, your friends, whatever, of course. But yourself, first of all, it goes through us, and we will send this particular session out to the frontline workers who are doing a phenomenal job. We know this. And yeah, so the nurses, the porters, the cleaners, the doctors, the waste disposal people, the firefighters, the ambulance crews, the Gardaí, the military, the army, the navy, the air corps, the suppliers, the shop workers, everyone else. I, you know, there are myriad, millions, loads of people. Thank you to them for being there for us. They're literally there. They are the frontline workers. They are in the trenches. And thank you. Thank you to them for their work, their hard work, their love, their insistence, and their consistent work. So yeah, so there you go. So this Reiki session, please join me. I will ask, I will call upon your higher selves. I will ask anyone who's not used to these words to say, "I'm open and ready to receive." And also, as well, later on, if you feel like it, even in the repeat, the replay, if you're watching the replay, thank you. If you're watching live, thank you. But let me know where you're watching from. Just a pure curiosity. I want to see how far this goes, to be honest. There you go. Is it market research? I don't know, but we'll see. So yeah, so zaps out. I'm gonna bash out some zaps, and I'll see you in about 5 minutes. All right, thanks. And we'll envisage that we're all holding hands. Okay, so how's that for a little bit of Sunday love? Okay, so see you in a few minutes. Thanks. Yeah, if we bring ourselves back gently and we put one hand over the other, we hold on to that light and let the light get brighter and brighter, the energy. We bring that light into our chest, into our heart. We let that light shine for us today. We shine it out, let the energy go where it needs to go. We just wriggle our fingers, stretch up, yawn. Wiggle our toes. And I'm gonna bring us back down with some ground us, not bring us down. A different workshop. I'm gonna ground us with some chimes, some bells, whatever. Yeah, there you are. So listen. Thanks for joining in. Really appreciate it. And so go about your day. Have a lovely day. Mind yourselves. Mind how you feed your mind. Keep on keeping on. Let's get it on. And let me know in the comments later on or whatever where you're watching from. Just want to see. Just again, pure curiosity. So I'm watching from the internet, man. Ooh. So mind yourselves. And again, like I said, mind how you feed your mind. And again, thank you for joining in. So, love and light and rock and roll. See you out there. Enjoy your day. Love to you and love to me.